Hello student, welcome to Vastec channel. This is Vasus Naik from Vastec channel. I will continue this session, microprocessor and microcontroller. Today our topic is segmentation, very important. I have already explained my previous video, what is segment? Segment is nothing but blocks of memory, clear? So normally processor is connected to, microprocessor is interfaced to memory. Memory is divided into blocks and that block is called a segment. Usually the size of the segment is 64 KB. So we know 8086 can address 1 MB memory. So in that 1 MB we can make around 16 segments. So in the diagram you can see 16 segments are there normally nearly, and randomly selected code segment, data segment, extra segment and stack segment. Let us take the expanded view of the data segment. Here you can see this is the expanded view of the data segment. It starts at 4000 and it ends at this one 4FF 64K. Similarly you can see extra segment, similarly data segment. Let's now explain this one. This is the actual 1 MB memory. Let me say one segment here starting from 1000 to 1FFF. This is 64 KB. Now in this this 10000 is called as starting address of the segment, and this starting address of the segment is transferred to segment register. You may ask how it will be transferred. How it will be transferred? Because we have doubt in our this one. The doubt is it is a 20 bit address and segment register is a 16 bit address. So normally 16 bit address is transferred. So here you can see normally we will transfer 16 bit from this 20 bit. So let me here clarify. This is 20 bit address and we transfer the left 4 digits 16 bit to segment register. Now any location, let me take this location. What is the address of this location here? This location address is F0000. This is called as offset address. Any location at offset address. How to form the physical address from the offset address? They will give you segment address. You have to multiply the segment address by 10. That time you will get the 10,000. And you have to add offset address. You have to add offset address. That will give you the particular 20 bit address. That will give you the particular 20 bit address. This is called as physical address. In the exam, they will give you segment address. Segment address is also 16 bit address. You have to multiply it by 10. Then it gives you starting address of that segment. For that, you have to add offset address. Then you will get 20 bit address. So that is the difference between physical address and offset address. Normally, we will write logical address. Logical address is nothing but a segment address, for example CS, and offset address. In this case, how I can write logical address? I can write logical address 1000 because I know segment address is 1000 : offset address is F000. This is logical address, 16 bit address, logical address. This contains both segment and this one offset. Segment you have to multiply by 10 and offset then you have to add the offset. Clear? Yes. Now, here you can see in the this is the exam question. 2500 is the offset address, sorry, segment address. And they will give offset address also. Normally code segment IP is the offset. They will not mention which is the offset. They will give just IP. Code segment IP is the offset. So you can see here, this is as I said in the earlier this one, this is logical address. 2500 and offset. Then 2500 you have to multiply by 10 and you have to add 95F3. You will get a 20-bit address. Then what is the starting address of the segment? This is the starting address of the segments. What is the ending address of the segment? If they ask that question, ending address of the segment, for starting address of the segment, you have to add FFFF. Why FFF? Each segment will be 64K. When you add, use your calculator and add this one. This will give you ending address of the segment. This is in between segment. Physical address of the in-between segment. So now here also, see this one. Code segment is given, code segment is given, IP is given, and they will ask logical address, offset address, physical address, lower range, upper range, etc. So logical address, how you write logical address? Code segment, colon, offset. What is offset here? I told you, when you use code segment, offset is normally IP. So logical address. What is offset address? IP is the offset address. And what is physical address? You have to calculate. How you have to calculate? You have to multiply this by 10. That is, this will become 24F60 in hexadecimal. Take the calculator and do this one. And add 634A and add it. You will get this one. Then what is the starting range? Starting range means starting address of the segment. Starting address of the segment, this is the starting address. What is the ending range? I have told you, this is the ending range. You have to get, you have to add FFFF. See, students will do the mistake. Student will add FFFF to this address. This is the big mistake student will do. No, we have to add FFFF to our segment address, not to this address. This is the any location in the segment, 20-bit address for any location. You have to add the FFFF to the starting address of the segment to get the ending address of that segment. Please remember this one. So now, so let me explain this one first. In the exam, they will not mention offset. So you have to think, they will give various registers with value. You have to think which is offset. For example, code segment IP is the offset. Data segment, if they give SIDI, SIDIBX, this will become offset. For stack segment, SP and BP becomes the offset. And extra segment, SID and BX. Please remember this table. This becomes the offset address. Now, let me take this one. Here you can see data segment. Here this is a straightforward question. Data segment is the address is given here. And offset is given 1950. Straightforward question. Multiply data segment with 10. Add offset. You will get physical address for that address. Now, in the exam, if they give like this, no problem. But sometime they will give. Assume that data segment register is 5886. That is starting address of the data segment register. To access the given byte of data at the physical memory location, 67F66. Does the data segment cover the range where the data resides? If not, odd change need to be made. So here you see starting address is 5786. Let me take a pen. 5786. So 5786, when you multiply by 10, this becomes this much. for this to get ending address of that segment. Ending address of that, this is the starting address, ending address of that segment, you have to add a FFFF. When you add FFFF to this one, you will get, let me write the answer here, you will get 67 8 B F. So starting address is this one, ending address is this one. But what is the memory location is given? 67 F66. This will come out of this range. The memory location comes out of this range. So I can say, if the starting address of this segment is this one, this will not becomes the memory location, offset or memory location in this segment. So to make this as the part of this segment, you have to change the starting address of the data segment. That is the answer. Is it clear? See, this is the starting address. This is the ending address. And you see here, what is the given address? This address comes out of this range. So I can say that is not the part of that segment. Given address is not the part of that segment. And he has asked, if not, what changes need to be made? That means DS must be changed to so that range will include that byte. Clear? Yes.